Just shake it off. started. We're going to make our dough first. Valerie, are you ready? Okay. We are ready. I'm trying, as if there wasn't enough background noise going on. I have my two boys in the house, a dog and a puppy, and a husband wandering around. So just bear with me. Anything goes. We might have some cameos. Just we're all in this together, everybody. So deep breath. If you're nervous about using yeast, please don't be. This is why how you conquer those fears. You just start, throw your hands right in the mixing bowl and you start doing it. So then the more you do it, the more you're like, wait, make things with dough, like all sorts of breads and delicious things. So we're going to start right now by demystifying the process of making something with yeast. Now, some people use yeast all the time. Oh, it's better now. Okay, great. Nice headband, Lane. Thanks, Mom. It actually says cookies. I don't know if it's like, yeah, but I don't know. Alright, so, you've got this. Yes, thanks, Brenda. So, Valerie's going to make a batch, and I'm going to make a batch, because these are so good, I'm not sharing. So, into your medium-sized mixing bowl. Oh, wait. I'm getting a little bit thrown today. We're going to activate our yeast first, because that's going to take a few minutes to go. So, everyone should get their liquid measuring cup, and you're going to pour in your warm water. My water is already warm. So you're going to measure 1/2 cup of warm water. Now, if yours goes a little above the half, that's fine. I'd rather you have a little over than a little bit under, okay? Because we don't want, look at this spilled out. We're in our own kitchen. You're going to pour 1/2 cup. So just this in 1/2 cup. Look, that's only 1/2 cup. So this, you're going to go there. So I'd rather have you, it's like a smidge more water than a smidge too less, because we don't want our dough to be dry. It's easier to remedy a slightly wetter dough than it is a dry dough. So now we're going to put into our water, our warm water, we're going to put our 1 1/4 teaspoon of yeast. Okay. So I've got 1 1/4, so do 1/4 and then 1/4 of it. And I'm going to, what's that? 1/4. I know there's not a lot in there, and I just ordered some more yeast from Cook Shop Plus because I was getting low. Yep, 1/4. Yep. Mm-hmm. You have to close the door because the neighbors are working on the garage. You never know what's going to happen. Yep, perfect. So we're going to put that in there, and then I'm going to put 1/2 teaspoon of sugar, because if you remember from our focaccia bread class, I'm just going to pour that in there too. You can stir those two up, so stir up your yeast. So the sugar acts as food for our yeast. So can you stir mine up too? Okay. So we've got 1/2 cup of water, 1 1/4 teaspoon of yeast, and 1/2 teaspoon of salt. Vance, can you stop coming in and out, please, please? I need 30 minutes. Just 30 minutes, Vance. Please. I just need some peace. Okay, so once you've stirred it up,
that's it.
Because what we need to do now is have the yeast and the water activate. So we're going to let it sit, and we're going to let it do its job. So it should start foaming, but I don't want you to envision this like rapidly bubbling thing. It's just going to start slowly kind of churning a little bit. Valerie's rushing me. Okay. All right, so into your mixing bowls. Yes, so 1 1/3 cup. So here we go. So 1 1/3 cup of flour right into your mixing bowl. Yep. Now this is not going to make 16 cinnamon buns. This is probably going to make about 9, small to medium sized cinnamon buns. Although you can sort of shape them however big that you want. And I guess I need to start mentioning all of my cinnamon bun facts, because there are so many recipes for cinnamon buns. A lot of them have egg in the recipe, which is why most of the recipes take 90 minutes to rise. So we are sort of doing, so that would be a traditional sort of sweet dough. So what we are doing is we are sort of like circumventing that step. And these are sort of my take, yep, so you've got that, my take on a traditional cinnamon bun. So we're making a plain white dough. yeast of dough that we are going to add the cinnamon bun filling to, and it will take not as much time at all. All right, so we've got our flour. We are going to add half of a teaspoon of salt into our flour. No, so this is actually a full cup of water, half teaspoon. So there. You know what, I need to grab a fork for myself. So I've got that. So you're just going to incorporate your flour, your 1 1/3 cups of flour, yep, and your half a teaspoon of salt. I just joined Facebook to watch you and Valerie goes, oh, hey, I'm Mona, hi, how are you? That chocolate chip bundt cake was so good. I haven't made it in years, if ever. Yay, Waxmans are here just to watch. That's so great.
What is this?
Yep, so you can use that same fork that you mixed up your yeast and your sugar. So this is what our yeast is looking like right now. We're going to give it a few more minutes to sort of start activating, which is why we put our 1 1/3 cups of flour, half a teaspoon of salt. I'm just gonna check through my ingredients to make sure that I'm not forgetting anything, which is why even though if you've made a recipe 1,000 times, you might still want to, keep the recipe printed out. I know I always do. All right, so we've got our sugar. I'm gonna put that to the side. We've got our salt and our flour. So we're doing our salt to our yeasty sugar water because salt kills yeast, and I know that's a very dramatic way of saying that, but it does. So that would inhibit growth, and we want to inhibit growth. So we want to make sure that we want our dough to have a little bit of salt in it, but we don't want to deactivate the yeast or not activate it at all. Same here, we went to 2 places. No joy, I know. I ordered mine online from a local place on town yeast, and people are saying that they're having trouble finding yeast. I ordered it online, and I may have gotten the last bag because then my other friend went to go get some right after. And Mom, you have flour and salt in the bowl, a half a teaspoon of salt.
Do
you? Yep.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So what we have to do is when we have to get our dough kind of situated and kneaded, and then it's going to rise. That's okay. That's what just a little bit of sugar. All right, so I want you to pull your, because I don't want to forget this step when we do get to it. I want you to peek in and see what's going in your yeast. Mm-hmm. So you're going to have, you can see that little level. It looks almost like ombre. That means that our yeast is good and it's activated. And so active dry yeast is sort of an interesting thing. It's sort of this kind of, which is why I choose to use water that's a little bit more warm, because I'd rather it work and not use water that's too weak. And my neighbor's texting me who's baking along, but I can't reply to you, Michelle. I'm so sorry. All right. Michelle is the one with the beautiful daffodil that's lining her walk. So every time you walk by her house, we admire the beautiful daffodils walk up her walk. All right. So, I don't want to rush anyone's yeast. I don't want to rush anyone's yeast, but the next step is what we're going to do. It's Valerie's looks. See, Valerie's sort of taken off even a little bit more so than mine at this point, but the thing is, this is going to work. We don't want it to rise, it's not going to fill up this whole 2-point measure, but what we want to do is just make sure that it's active. Totally looks active on my end, and I hope. I'm getting yelled at by my mother here. Speak up, please. Ma, I am.
Is your mom?
Did we go through this already? It might help if you put earbuds on, and then that's just a direct connection from me to you. You're swimming, not cooking. That's so funny. So, I want to keep moving on because we have a few steps to go here. So, thank you so much for everyone who is tuning in, cooking, watching, being amused, or just killing a little time on your day. So you have your flour, 1 1/3 cup, and a half a teaspoon of salt in your bowl. Here we have half of a cup of warm water with 1 1/4 teaspoons of yeast, and I think you put in a half a teaspoon of sugar there. So what you're going to do now, what if the yeast isn't doing anything? Cheryl, so it's not doing anything, like not any even little churning at the top. Is there anyone in your home that can confirm? I wonder, if your yeast worked when you made focaccia, hopefully that makes it a little bit louder for everyone. Yes, half of a teaspoon of sugar goes in the water in yeast. Yep, and that's what it's gonna look like after about 5 minutes. Okay, I guess I was just having a distance issue because I was trying to get everyone in my shot, but you know what? It doesn't always have to be perfect, which is a prime example of that today. It's doing it now. Okay, great. Yes. All right, so our yeasty sugary water is at the step where we are going to move on. Sounds is much better if you use AirPods, yeah. Mm-hmm. All right, so I'm going to grab my, yep, that's fine. So what we're gonna do next is just into our yeast and our water, because we're gonna get ready to kind of form this dough. You're going to put in 2 teaspoons of oil. I'm actually gonna probably put 3. So why we're adding this oil, it's sort of why you add a oil to a cake. It's just gonna help us with our kneading. It's gonna help us smooth things out. So I've added that to my yeast water. You can see that. And so I've got water, yeast, sugar, and canola oil. I did 2 to 3 teaspoons of oil. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you did. That's probably, I think you're using the tablespoon. That's what I do. All right, so what we're going to do is I'm just going to keep plowing along here, and we'll take time to ask questions. So grab your fork quickly. All right, so I'm going to just start pouring my water and my yeast and the oil. Yep, everyone's going to do this at the same time. So now what we're going to do is we're just going to use our fork. If you were using a spoon or something, that's fine too. But I like to use a fork just because it's everybody has one, and it shows that you don't need anything too fancy when you're cooking. Okay. Yep. So put in the oil. So you want to get that oil in there. Okay, Austin. Can you... All right. So I've got my dough. I'm stirring it around to where it's the point of, I guess they would say in professional terms, awesome, the shaggy mess. My son has arrived in the kitchen and he's decided to make a glass of ice water. So what we're going to do is after we have stirred it up enough, we're going to get our hands right in the bowl. And this is why I sort of said it's better at this point if you have a half a cup of water and you overestimate a little bit, then underestimate. Yep, so you're just gonna start pushing it down. So I've got my bread, my dough here. I've only got a little bit left in my bowl that I'm just gonna sprinkle on top. Yep. I'm gonna help Valerie get a little bit of hers out of the bowl. Can I just do yours from the top? Oh wow, your dough. So also, it also helps with the warm water. Hi, Abby. The warm water helps because then you'll see your dough is nice and soft. So as you can see, I'm in Valerie's bowl here, and I'm mixing as much as I can in the bowl before I take it out. So Valerie has just a little bit of flour and butter on the side. So now what she's going to do, I'm going to move this so we have like a clear shot. Now we're just going to start kneading on our countertop. And as you can see mine, I'm just going to start kneading, and this is the point where I hope everyone is, and if they've used the right amount of water and added that oil to your dough, it's a nice soft dough. And all we're trying to do now is we're just sort of kneading the dough. I have a little cup of flour here in case I need to just pinch, just to sprinkle a little bit on my cutting board. Now, I don't want you to add too much flour. If you're feeling like it's sticky, it's better to take your time and do it right, and do it slow, add slowly flour. You just want to sprinkle your counter, because we don't want to have this hard rock of dough. And I hope none of you are. I feel absolutely horrible. But if you can sort of see, I'm not pressing down with all my might. Yes, Valerie, so all you're going to just go, you're just going to keep rolling, and you're sort of forming it into a circle. And you're just going to need, I'm so happy that all of you guys have joined us. You've put up with our technical difficulties. You may even still be experiencing them. And
is this good?
Yep, so you're just gonna keep doing it. We're gonna knead for about 3 to 4 minutes. What if it's too dry? Then you should add in a splash more of warm water or even a little more of the oil. Just like a splash, a tablespoon. If it's very sticky, just sprinkle on some more flour. And then you're just gonna keep kneading it. So mine now, and because this is such a little amount of dough, I mean, it's only 1 1/3 cups of flour, so this isn't, you know, those big doughy, you know, recipes that have 5 to 7 cups of flour. So this is just, this is intended, honestly, it's intended for when I do classes with kids, so that everyone gets their own small ball of dough to work with. And that's why it rises faster, and that's why we can do this all in, you know, sort of reasonable amount of time. Mm-hmm. So if your dough is too sticky, just sprinkle on a little bit more dough. In mine, because that water was nice and warm that we used, I can actually feel it rising as I am rolling it, which is a very cool thing. And so you feel like, wow, if you don't use yeast a lot, this is something that's completely manageable, and that it's more than a life skill. This is, you know, nourishment and basics. And Valerie's forming her into a ball, and you know, kneading is sort of one of those things where you can do it as for almost as long as you want. So I'm sort of smoothing out the top, and then I just sort of fold over and I push down on my counter. I'm using my counter to help smooth the top of this dough. So then what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna form it into this. I'm gonna get it so that you can see it over there. So you're just gonna form it into a little ball. I mean, it's not perfectly smooth, but I am completely 1,000% happy with what's going on here. And so on the bottom, as you can see, it's just more of a little. Yep. So I am going. Oh, actually, so I've got a little bit of a tea towel. I'm going to cover the top and cover the top of my dough and just give it a little blankie. Can I just shape? Your dough, Valerie's dough, feels amazing. It's probably because of the tablespoon of extra oil you put in there. So I'm no, it's great. If it's too dry, oh, I think we answered that question. I love that families are baking together. Greenspan fam and my own fam. Oh, where's the phone? All right, so I've got Valerie's. She's very annoyed that I've taken over. I mean, look at her face. She's just disgusted with me. Okay. So there's Valerie's. I'm going to put hers under my little blanket. So we've got two little buns here. And we're going to put them to sleep. I'm going to move these to the side. Ours is still so sticky. So actually what I'm going to do is sprinkle a little flour on the side and put my dough on top. If it still is too sticky, I would just say keep adding in a little bit more flour, but you want to really find that balance where it's not too much, where it gets too hard. So hopefully that it's warm and you're able to sort of knead it in and just add in a pinch at a time, or maybe, you know, a tablespoon at a time might even be too much. You don't have to dampen the tea towel. I didn't. My dough was nice and warm, so I feel like it's the perfect, and it's not going to stick to the tea towel. So what we're going to do now, some people I bet are still in the kneading phase, some people have their yeast still rising. We are going to take a 3-second kind of break here to clean off our countertops and prepare the next thing that we're going to do while our dough is rising, since this is sort of a 3-step to 4-step process. We are going to clean up our countertops and just work clean, as they say. Working clean is one of the most important lessons when you're baking or cooking, because, and I've probably said this every week, if you're baking and your kitchen is in a huge, messy explosion, that's not a good incentive to have your kids bake or cook, or even yourself. So learning how to, it's called mise en place, if you prep your ingredients out ahead of time so that you can just sort of strategically remove things. So I'm going to put my dishes in the sink. We'll deal with those later. I'm going to sort of remove anything that I don't need for the rest of this time here. So my yeast I'm going to clean up. I'm going to take my salt away. And I'm just going to put it on my back counter. And hopefully everyone's oven is at 350, preheating, creating a nice warm, cozy environment in your kitchen. like sugar anymore. I might need a teaspoon. I'm going to take my forks away, my bowl. We don't need any more oil. Alright. I'm just going to keep sort of chatting away here. I don't even believe we need any. Oh, wait, you know what? We do need a little bit more flour for the cinnamon filling. So, a dish towel is perfect. Yep. I am using, the funny thing is, I don't know why my recipe, it said dark brown sugar. You can use light brown sugar. You can use dark brown sugar. You can use whatever you have. I sent my husband to the store this week. He does our weekly shop for sort of other things that I can't just order, my fruit and vegetable order. And he came.
And
he buys all the Doritos and the garbage food, which is why my dad goes shopping. My husband brought home a bag of dark brown sugar of all the things because I said, "Can you just get a bag of brown sugar?" Actually, I specifically said, "Not dark brown sugar," but you know, whatever. I'm glad he had it. He figured
it
out.
Didn't you say it needed dark brown sugar?
No, it said I said you could just eat it. So. What we're going to do, hopefully you have created a nice clean workspace. I'm going to just do this. Great, but I actually had enough of it.
Oh wait, this is a little bit back there.
She's all of a sudden decided to ask me a question about something. Our dough is rising. I'm going to sort of move my camera. But there's a glare coming off my back window. But here, my little dough balls are rising. So that's the other thing about just using a recipe with a smaller amount of flour. Granted, I'm not going to get as many cinnamon buns, but it doesn't take as long to rise. So, we're going to assemble the brown sugar filling. Valerie, come on, honey. Let's go back. We're going to do our filling. It's like hurting cats. So I have a smaller mixing bowl. We are going to mix together 1/3 cup of brown sugar. Truthfully, if you wanted to use more brown sugar, you could. But I've found I've made this a bunch of times. And I'm just packing it down. Nothing fancy or too technical. Valerie, do you want to pack any brown sugar? This is actually a fun thing. So she's gonna do it. Valerie's gonna pack herself down. We do need. Oh boy, the mailman's coming. My dog's about to lose her mind in about 5 seconds. So I really, really hope it doesn't get too crazy. She hears that mailman. She just goes nuts. Oh my gosh. It's okay, Perky. It's fine. So 1/3 cup of brown sugar, 1 tablespoon of flour. We are going to do 3/4 teaspoon of cinnamon, but I'm going to do a big sort of heap because I love the cinnamon, and these are cinnamon rolls. So we want to make sure that there's a lot of cinnamon in there. Yep, so put it right in your bowl. Good job. So then you're just going to do sort of a big scoop of flour, so 1 tablespoon. Mm-hmm, that's very satisfying. So you're going to do a big scoop of flour, or maybe 2 of those big ones, into your bowl. My stick of butter.
And then how many of this?
1 big scoop of the cinnamon. So we have. So we're making sort of that soft, buttery cinnamon sugar filling. So this is what it looks like first. Valerie's got hers. I've got. It's hard to figure out the angles of the cameras. There we go. 350. Yep, Jody. Hey, Sadowski fam. we're also going to do put in here 2 tablespoons of soft. I softened it. So it's not melted, but and I'm going to be super generous with the butter. And Valerie's got her spreader, so you can use a fork, you can use a spoon, so you've got your butter.
Do I like?
Yeah, so I'm going to sort of do a, it's sort of a press method. You just want to incorporate it, and if a little bit rolls on your counter, no worries. So you've got butter, so I'm just really just dragging this together however you see fit. Yep, so we really want to just incorporate the butter, the sugars, the one sugar, the brown sugar, the cinnamon, and that flour. Things down to combine all of those ingredients. If you feel like it's a little bit dry and you need to add a little more butter, go right ahead and be my guest. Now this is the perfect activity to do while your dough is rising. Just, you know what? I think that my little spreader there isn't cutting it, so I'm just going to get in there and work it around with my hands.
What is this?
And create a little bit of a crumble. Because what we're going to do is we're going to spread this onto the dough. So sometimes the brown sugar has a little bit of, crunchy bits. If they're too hard and they don't automatically break up in a finger.
You gotta squeeze them with your hands.
Yeah, you gotta squeeze them with your hands. So I made a little bit of a brown sugary crumble. Is everything okay in your bowl? So it might take a minute or two, and that's good. We have that minute or two because we want our cinnamon dough to rise. I think Valerie's turning into a little chameleon or ham. I just wasn't talking, I just sort of was like focused on that. Do you want to switch? Would you like them to get in there? Do you? So, and also I gave everyone permission to just get in there and use their hands. Okay, Shauna, did you get that in? How much flour? 1 tablespoon flour, 2 tablespoons soft butter, 3/4 teaspoon of cinnamon. Honestly, it's a sort of a guesstimate with the cinnamon. You can just you can use melted butter. So if yours went a little bit past soft, oh, Valerie did have some little harder bits in her. Yep. All right, Valerie, did you wash your hands? So I've got butter and brown sugar and flour all in. So this is a part, like, this is basically how you make, oh, Valerie, please, let's not do that now. Let's not do that now, perfect. Okay? Let's do that after. She's trying to cut a hard piece of brown sugar.
It worked.
Thank you. Okay, let's go. Says 1 teaspoon flour. Yep. Teaspoon. If I said tablespoon, my bad. So what you're doing is making a crumble. This is a perfect streusel topping. Okay, so look, Valerie, I got yours there too. I'm going to step off for 1 second and wash my brown sugar. Mine is really liquidy. Well, if your butter was a little too, it's okay. It's okay if it is, because what happens with butter is that when it gets colder, or if it's going to sit out there, it'll sort of solidify a little bit. And it's okay if it's a little bit too liquidy. Maybe add in a little bit of more flour to sort of suck it up a little bit. So mine looks like that. It's sort of just a thick, brown, sugary mess. I'm going to leave my little spreaders. I hope the, who's that? Stacy, with the liquidy filling, you can add a little bit more flour.
And,
no, we're not making non-sugar sandwich right now. No, that's the last thing we need. I do love that creative mind. I can do it later. All right, so I've got this going here. I'm going check on my, I'm going to check on my dough. So hopefully you guys can do a dough check as well. I'm not touching your dough other than giving it a little pat. So how do you check the dough? How do you know it's ready? So you're going to just poke it a little bit, and you can see how it's springing back to me. That to me says, yeah, let's do it. That to me says we're in business. Now, as you can see, Valerie just got very territorial over her little pot with her little bun here, and I know why, because she's part of the job. So I'll give that to her. So what I'm going to do is going to step back here. So we have our dough here. I'm going to do this. I'm going to flip it over top. So see, it's not sticky.
Let's flip it over.
Yeah, I'm going to flip it over. Yep. But what we're going to do now is we're going
over in the...
Yep, so upside down. Because on the bottom, your bottom part that was on the counter might be a little bit sticky. So what you're going to do is we're just going to use our fingers. We don't... This is basically exactly what we did with the focaccia dough. But we don't want that. We don't really want the indents to last. But we're just going to use. You could get a rolling pin out if you wanted to, but I don't think you would. It would really almost be more effort to get. So we're just going to spread it out with our fingertips. Yep. And I'm going to, as I'm sort of going to be working it into a square. So. Hope all of your doughs are behaving and they're workable. And so we're just going to take a minute or two and just take some time with our dough. Very good working. Now, if you notice on the ingredient list, one of the ingredients is dental floss. Not because we're going to be eating it, but because that's one trick. Obviously, you could use a knife. Oh, well, everyone knows what to do. So I'm just going to roll this out. So I've got this thin. Go ahead, show everybody. Yay, yours is perfect. I'm so thrilled. So I've got more of a rectangle going here. I want... Because if you haven't made cinnamon rolls before, this process is we're flattening the dough out a little bit. Mine's probably about a quarter of an inch thick. I'm dying to know what's going on in all your kitchens. Lori, Brandon, is it successful? Did the yeast work? I've been getting texts and emails about people that are nervous about having the dough. And I really am excited to see what's going on. All right. So I've got my... Yep, you can use a rolling pin, but I was just going to demonstrate that you don't have to. Mine's like this. It's a rectangle, sort of misshapen, but Valerie, it's beautiful. Oh, good work, Kirk. So, if you've got your, so far so good, yay! If you've got your brown sugar filling, I'm going to use a little sandwich spreader. You can use a butter knife, and we are just going to spread the filling. That's why I said if it's a little bit liquidy, that's okay. I would hope that it wouldn't, you know, if it was something that wasn't like dripping out the sides. But honestly, the softer, it's the better, the softer, the easier to, the more soft it is, the easier it'll be to spread. So we've got that going for us. If yours was a little bit too soft. Yep, so you don't want to like dig in onto your dough, but you just want to gently press it on top. Valerie is saying, yep, and honestly, a little, if you want to just use your fingers and sprinkle it around.
Yes.
Yeah, go right ahead and do that. I think a lot of people get see someone like me who's coming out, oh my God, oh my dough, it's so perfect, and my filling is perfect, and everything's so perfect. And I've been doing this for many, many years. I've made this recipe many times, and years ago I would make it and it would fail too. Actually, I still have some fails. And so I don't want you to be discouraged. You're like, oh wow, she makes it look so easy. And truthfully, it is easy, but I feel like confidence. I think I'm helpful to some, so
I'll just say it's actually really easy.
No, I'm just saying it gets easier the more and more you do it. It's
mine
moral
so
of the story.
Mine is
right, that's totally fine. So because what's going to happen once these get in the oven, the butter and the everything's going to sort of spread out. So I'm going to show you what Valerie's looks like. So that's fine if yours looks like that and mine looks like that. This is not a contest for prettiest, you know. I got this little tripod. And so this is not a contest for prettiest pre-bake. Actually, you know what? I do want to make sure if it's spread out to the corners, because when we roll up that cinnamon dough, those are going to be our end pieces. And we want to make sure the end pieces get some love. Okay? You're doing it perfect. Alright, so what we're going to do is we're going to start at the very bottom and just roll over, I don't know, about a half of an inch. And we're just going to make a tight little roll. And you kind of just have to do it. And so as I... Nope, so this is perfect, the Valerie's. So I'm going to, as I'm rolling it, I'm going to pull back a little bit.
That's what I'm doing.
And then roll over again. So if you saw that picture that I posted on my Instagram or Facebook yesterday, I had these perfect cuts, and this is how I'm doing it, because I'm rolling it, but then I'm pulling back. And that's how you get more of the rolls. And so if you can see your cinnamon rolls are, you can pull the dough out on the sides a little bit, if you can see that. So that it all stays together. And this is sort of one of those moments where normally if you're baking alone.
Oh yeah, Mom.
Oh yeah, look at Valerie's. I'm gonna move it in just a sec, but I wanna show.
What's mine? The ends look so good.
So the ends
mine
won't get pointy if you pull over the dough to the side.
So should I roll the ends too?
Hold on, Valerie, hold on. So I've rolled it. I'm gonna pull it back here. I've got my end seam there that I'm going to sort of just pinch together. It doesn't have to be anything too fancy. These are not gonna... I'm just taking, pinching. What if there's not enough filling? Then just keep rolling. Yep, you can make it really thin because it'll all be in there. Okay, so I have got my... So what we're doing with Valerie's is we're going to roll it over because you want the seam to be on the bottom. And if you're finding that yours got to be really long, you're just going to sort of tap in the ends because you want it to be about, how long is this?
Foot.
No, this is my, yeah, so this is about, I don't know, 11 inches? Be super exact. This is just sort of how mine came out. Yes, perfect. So Valerie's had a little bit of like a little bit too long in the end, so I'm just showing her how to kind of tighten it up. It's perfect. You're gonna eat it in a little bit. Okay. So this next part is where the dental floss comes in. Now I'm giving myself just a decent amount of dental floss. You could also use a knife at this step. So, what I'm going to do first, because I want to have an even number of rolls. Valerie, listen to me. Watch this, because... And I'm going to take the dental floss and slide it under. And I'm going to get to the middle spot. I'm sort of going to visualize it before I make any cuts. So then I've got my two sides of dental floss. I'm going to lift it up and just cross it. And then pull it. So that's what the middle looks like. Ta-da! So we've got two hopefully equally long sides. And I have this sort of weird thing where I have a very, very good perception on measuring. So if Valerie's having a little trouble because there's a little sticky. Well, if it won't go all the way under, you just have to pull it. So, Valerie, go ahead, show them how you do the... Valerie's having a little, we call it flopping in our house. We call it flopping. Right, so you want to get to that center part? Nope, it isn't stuck. All we're just using this as a guide. Okay, and just... You've got to match it. You've got to match it. It's okay. Match it. Oh, there we go. You did it. Oh, and you have six more tries. And look at Valerie's. Woo! It does look good. Let's have some positivity, Perkins. This is not, we did not come here to cry or get upset. Okay? All right. So, I think I'm going to make six. Or should I make eight? Should I make six or eight? I don't know. I think I'm just going to make six. Well, I guess if we made eight, they would. I think I am going to make eight. So then what you do is you find that middle spot. Oh, yeah, definitely. Definitely eight. Because then they would take forever to bake, so then I did it again. So I found that center spot. Yes, definitely make eight, people, because as I forgot, they're going to puff a little bit. So you find that middle spot. So now I've got these little cinnamon bun logs, but I'm not done yet because I'm going to go again. And I'm going to find that center spot of each of these. And this is just, you know, simple, simple. And there we go. These are our little buns. And the cool thing is that we're taking a little time here, so these are actually getting their a little bit of a rise. Oh, you had an oh wow moment. See, ta-da! Now, I hope the dental floss is not stressing anyone out, or any of the parents out, because that's the last thing I want to do, is stress anyone out. So just use a serrated knife or a sharp, paring knife. Yes, that's right, there's no crying and baking. And we've got our sixth. If that one looks so small, it's okay. You know, my little end piece is going to be a little bit smaller than the others. In there. I've got my final two pieces. Which way do you roll it? The shorter, go shorter. So you're going to have, like a rectangle. So you want to start at the shorter end and have the longer sides and roll up the sides. You think the dental floss is fine? Yay! There's a new tip. Also, keep flossing. I floss every night. So now what we're going to do is, you can see I have my eight perfect little cinnamon buns. I am going to, well, you could do a few things. If you had a cake pan, go right ahead, an 8-inch round cake pan. You can put them on that. Valerie, do you want to go on the same sheet with me? Sheet. So I've got Valerie's tray. Hers are more. They really are. I'm gonna get some parchment for Perky. So we've been watching High School Musical 1, 2, and 3, and Valerie found this hat that the neighbor gave her, the one that she's been wearing, and she realized it was just like a Sharpay.
Not Sharpay,
Sharpay or Sharpay's brother wears a hat like that. And so we are just feeling it. So Valerie's got hers. I've got mine here. I might play around with them a little bit to form them into a little bit of a circle. Because these will sort of bake together. Mine's going to be a little random. So if you did have a little, oh, I know, that's on there. All right. So I've got mine together. They're going to puff up and they're going to sort of come together. This is the stage where it's like, oh, these are like those popping fresh rolls that we had every holiday morning growing up. How many rolls are we supposed to have? I have eight. If you have six, that is also okay. Love the dental ball. Cheryl Green, I can't, as I'm teaching you a new trick, I am just so floored and proud. And so, yeah, the dental floss helps you make get the nicest, cleanest cut ever. As you're putting them on your tray, you know, if you have a side that looks like that, that was my end, keep that on the bottom and put that as your presentation side. So put the...
Mine looks like super.
Oh, boy. Look at Valerie's. Okay, everyone, so this is where we're at with the kids or adults. And then these ones are mine. So everyone is baking at their different level, and we are all doing it together. So what I'm going to do is I'm getting these. How many will... no, they don't have to be in a circle. I kind of have them. They're in sort of a weird shape. So what we're going to do is we need to get these babies in the oven. All right, so I'm going to turn around. Get these in the oven. She's informed me that the oven needs cleaning. Well, let me put that right on the list. I'm going to set my timer for about 7 minutes because I want to check them. And I was just thinking, Valerie's look great. Yep, they have lots of cinnamon. I actually put jeans on today. I woke up and I thought, you know what? I'm sick of the sweats. I'm going to put jeans on. And I did. So it actually feels better. I feel like a normal person. So now what we're going to do while our cinnamon rolls are baking, we are going to clean up our kitchen, and once our countertop gets cleaned up, we're going to make our glaze. So I hope that you will see us through here. I will stick with you right to the end till we get them out to tasting. I do understand if you need to, you know, hop off, that's fine. But I'd love for you to stick around so we can talk about how they look. How many minutes? Put them in the oven at 350. I'm going for 7 minutes for the first kind of bake. Total bake time, Ash, I think it's gonna be like 15 to 18 minutes. But as you saw on Valerie's tray, some are a little smaller. They're not consistent, all the same size, so I might cook a little bit faster. And that's okay too, because if this is your first time baking something like this, then it's a very big learning experience. Or you could just pull off some of the smaller ones if they're done and the rest of them need a few more minutes. That's what you can do. So I'm just gonna take a few minutes. Valerie, do you wanna just put some of these things in the sink? Get the kids cleaning. That's the hope. She just looked at me horrified. So we're gonna put what I'm going to keep out is my confectioner sugar. I have a fun story.
Oh, yeah.
I sent my husband, my husband does the shop, the Big Y, every week, because I just get so anxious until I have to go to the grocery store, and I will if I have to, but he does the big shop. He buys a lot of snacks and ramen for the kids and strange foods that I put on my list, vanilla and some baking things, some essentials. So he came back with this bottle of vanilla, this monster bottle, which I would never have bought for myself. I don't know why I would have gotten a smaller bottle, but he just saw it and he bought it. It was like a gift. Happy Mother's Day to me. So I've got this wonderful bottle of vanilla, that the best that Big Y had, which is actually a pretty decent spice island bottle. And you know what? Treat yourself. That's what you gotta do. And my husband treated me, and he didn't even realize he was gonna make me so happy with that very big bottle. I'm spilling the tea. Someone did mention, it was funny because, you know, what you work at, if you're working, you have a regular job, you're having them come together, or not your really, so it wasn't being called as much. What? Yep, you can use, you can just put them on your tray if you have a nonstick tray, that's fine too. You could put a little butter down on the sheet if you, on the tray too, if you don't have parchment paper. Thank you for that mention, because I don't want to assume that everyone is as obsessed with parchment, or use your silk hat. You remember, I discussed my love-hate relationship with silk hats, so I do not own one, but if you do have a silk hat, go right ahead. So, if you're like me, your cinnamon buns are in the oven. We are doing a quick counter cleanup. Or sort of something similar. confidence is key. So if you're baking with yeast, and you know what? You just got into this sort of cycle where people don't bake as much, or they're not baking with yeast as much, or they just say, well, I'll just put it in and I'll get a croissant. Well, you know what? Now is a great time to actually go back to basics and figure out how to make these things from scratch. Then you can realize, wait, I'm only paying $5 for a croissant, and I can just make my own for a whole batch of 24 for about that same price. So now that we have a little time to explore in the kitchen, it's a good time to sort of find a, you know, investigate a recipe that looks good and, you know, spend the afternoon or day or a few days whipping those up. So sit up. So croissants in here too. Well, yes, because you have to incorporate layers of butter and then you have to rotate them and fold and you're incorporating all those layers. Mm-hmm. So that wouldn't be a good one to do on a Facebook Live. I'd say, okay, meet back in 3 days and we will cut and bake off our croissants. So I probably won't do that on a Facebook Live. Wouldn't that be funny?
Mm-hmm.
Everyone come back at 5 p.m. and we will finish our... Don't do that today. So when we're doing these Facebook Lives, one of the things that we're doing is we're trying to have recipes that we can bake in about an hour from start to finish. I will announce what our recipe for next week is. It is. Is the filling supposed to be leaking out? I mean,
it
might be. It's warm. It might be leaking out. It just depends on how soft it was. If you're talking about in the oven, sure, that would be, you know, kind of a dream if it does leak out. If you're talking about when it's baking or if you're talking about when you're actually rolling, filling out. I was just about to make my big announcement. So what we're going to do next week, we are going to do a recipe for a perfect pound cake. Now, all of the ingredients are things that you should have at home, and pound cake, it's like loaf cake, it's the best thing ever. It's just like a cake. So we haven't done anything like that before. So you can use a 5x9 loaf pan, you can use 3 or 4 little mini loaf pans. In this recipe, you could use vanilla extract, you could use almond extract if you have it. So it's sort of there's a little bit of citrus zest in it, lemon, lime, grapefruit, orange, whatever you have, a combination of everything. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to make perfect pound cake. And I love pound cake, I do. You can really just gobble it down or make, you know, strawberry shortcakes or any sort of anything. I mean, just eat it. And so that's what's going on next week. What we're going to do, now I just glanced back at my timer and I have 30 seconds till the timer goes back for my first 7-minute check. Wait, what is it? Amanda, did you hear it? It's pound cake. You're making this pound cake recipe that I found on the New York Times Cooking, which I'm sort of obsessed with. I pay for the subscription, so I am giving you a recipe that you may not normally have access to. It's a recipe, but I am giving her credit. Perfect pound cake. Oh, so there's my timer. Let me grab my... Oh boy. So my husband also buys Snapple. I haven't had Snapple since the late 90s, but now all of a sudden it's back in the way. Okay, so this is at 7 minutes. This is a mid-bake 7 minutes. They look amazing. So I'm rotating my pan. I'm just one of those over-checkers, and so, oh no, I didn't hear it. Sorry, that sounds really good. Okay, good. So now what we're going to do is we're going to whip up our glaze. So we are going to put a cup of, well, I'll do mine and you do yours. I'm getting, oh, Valerie, you know what, you have to keep doing this, your Zoom, I think. Go up to the class. Valerie is not going to be making her glaze. She just realized. Just tell your teacher, I'm sorry you're late. I'll send you out again. Oops. So I will be manning the forks. You don't think your dough is risen enough? Is it? I don't know if it's in the oven or not yet, Lori. Yep, I'm going to put a cup in. Because confectioner sugar sort of Once you add water, it actually gets a little bit smaller than you think. I don't know if that made any sense. But I've got a little bit of water. I've got a tablespoon. A cup of confectioner's sugar. So my bag's upside down. But you know, powdered sugar. So that's going to be our white icing on the top. So we are going to put in confectioner's sugar. I'm going to do a splash of vanilla. And I am going to use that gingerly because I want this to last forever. Now you know what to get me if you want to get me a gift. Nice vanilla. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to start with 2 tablespoons of water. Because what we want is we want thick but spreadable. Okay, so we don't want it to be too thin by adding in too much water right out of the gate. So I started with a splash of vanilla and 2 tablespoons of water and 1 cup of sugar. So this one, as you can see, the confectioner sugar is getting absorbed into that water. The water is absorbing into the confectioner sugar. Nailed this right on the first time. Now, depending on how warm your water is, how cold or hot it is in your kitchen, that's sort of the excuse for things going good or bad when you're baking or cooking. So you might need to use another tablespoon of water or a little bit, or if yours is a little bit too liquidy, mine is going, this is good. So what I want is I want it this thick. If not, because when we put it on top of the hot cinnamon buns, oh yeah. So I'm gonna use a little arm power. As you can see, it's thick but spreadable. So we don't want it to be too thin. So if you need to add a little bit more confectioner sugar, ooh, this looks smooth. So this is thick but spreadable. How many times did I just say that? Spreadable. Alright. So I'm gonna let that sit. I'm going to mix up Valerie's. Now, if you are a total cinnamon nut and you want to add a little cinnamon into your too, make a little cinnamon sugar glaze, go for it. I will not fault you there. So, how much water? So I just used 2 tablespoons of water and a splash of vanilla. Now I'm going to mix Valerie's up where I did the same thing, 2 tablespoons of water, but as I was sort of saying, it depends if you maybe had a little bit of a full cup or a little bit more than 1 cup of confectioner sugar. I mean, we didn't weigh it or anything. But Valerie's is coming together. Nicey, nice glaze. Guys, I can't believe you guys are hanging around with me. 54, oh, as I said that. You guys are still here. Thank you. Ours is a little more brown because we have added too much vanilla. Yeah, you might have. You might have added a little more than I do, which is totally fine. If you're not a vanilla fan, my sister is not. She hates vanilla. I don't even know if I know her. So I don't even know if she would add vanilla at this time. So if you just wanted to make it white, so there we go. Thick, 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 but spreadable. If that translates, that is what you want. So nice and thick. Like, see, it's not falling out of my bowl. So that's what we want. So we're going to set that aside. I can smell the cinnamon buns or cinnamon rolls, whatever you want to call it. That was 5 minutes. Yay, mine is not as white. Yeah, mine is not. That's okay. It's okay if it's not as white. It also just might be it's very bright in the back of my camera, so it might just be that. But the vanilla. So this is at 12 minutes. Mine just came out at 12 minutes. They're not done, but I'm showing them off to you. So I'm going to go to the end. Check Valerie's. Because hers were a little, I don't know if you can see that. There's like that little one right there. Needs a little love, but I'm going to put it back in. I'm going to put it back in for another 5 minutes. And that would bring us to 18 minutes. Figuring out how to work the microwave timer is also one of those things. So we've got our glaze, we've got our cinnamon buns. So that would be 17 minutes. So we're gonna put them in for 5, and then we're gonna see where we're at. Yes, some of mine are unrolling too. It's totally fine. Mm-hmm. So I've got a little extra cinnamon. So what I'm gonna do right now is I'm gonna just take a few minutes and just put some things away. I wanna show you that I have this mega thing of cinnamon that I got at BJ's, and I've actually used quite a bit of it. Not all of this quarantine, obviously, but so I'm gonna put back what I didn't use, and I'm doing that because I'm in my own home. I can do that. That would be called marrying one of those things I used to work in restaurants, when we were at Pickle Belly, or Rainforest Cafe when I was younger, and when you have a ketchup bottle that's half empty and another ketchup bottle that's half empty, and you marry them together by pouring in the top, and that's actually, I don't know if it's illegal is the right word, but it's not okay with the health department anymore, so I always get a little sketched out by ketchup bottles, especially the ones that are in this red squeezy bottles that aren't even labeled. You have no idea what's in there or how long it's been in there, but that's just one of my pet peeves. Yep, they're going to be golden brown, and what we're going to do is we're going to flip them over, I think. We're going to see what they are. And the thing is, it doesn't really matter if they are golden brown, because we're going to put the icing on top. And we didn't egg wash it or anything, which we weren't supposed to, so they won't. So if you're looking for that golden brown, these are not going to be, completely golden brown. No, Tara or Abby, I didn't put the cinnamon in the icing, but I suggested that if you wanted to, you could. It just got a lot brighter in here now that Valerie went back to school. My daughter's in third grade. She just is such an independent learner, and she really just has taken all of this on, all of this learning stuff at home, and she makes it so easy for me. And then my son who's 7 in second grade just makes it right up for me. So it's a little challenging. We've had our challenges. Like when we find out we have, a science project we have to talk about, and I think it's the most interesting thing in the world to learn about pandas. And my 7-year-old just doesn't get it. Just doesn't want to write about their diets and physical characteristics of the panda, even though we watched this great story on them, and all the info was right there. All he had to do was takes a few notes, not even in his best handwriting, and it just was a challenge for us this morning, but we're getting through it, so, oh good, Abby, I'm so happy you're having fun. How much longer should they be in the oven if we put them in at the same time as you? So I started up for 7, 5, 5, so that's 12 minutes, and then I just put them in for another 5, so that would be 17 minutes total, so I've got 90 seconds left, so they've been in there now for about 15 and a half minutes. Oh, I'm so glad this has been your favorite so far. I'm so happy those 2 people did all this. I hope Michelle, delete those first 2 Bosch Facebook Lives so people are watching them and saying, what is going on in this kitchen? Oh my gosh. Yours are light but hard. So what we're going to do, and I think mine are going to be done at this point, at 17 minutes. So Karen, I'm going to show you what you're going to do. So if they're done, as I had sort of mentioned before, if you've taken these other Tuesday classes with me, that everyone's oven is sort of like has its own, jurisdiction and heat, or your 350 might be 400 in my oven, so if you have an oven thermometer, that's the best kind of way. Mine really leaked too, yeah, mine did too. And enough will stay inside where you feel like, yep, mm-hmm. All right, so there's my timer. now. I am going to do a little investigation here to see what's going on in that center one, because that's the one I really want to... Oh, okay, here. Yep, these guys are done. Underneath, and that actually looks like the best little like caramelly yummy thing either. So I actually am going to do these a couple different ways. I think I'm going to ice the top side and get crazy, because those to me look like morning buns, because the bottom, the cinnamon sugar, is sort of caramelized. And the only one that doesn't look as cool are the two end pieces, because they didn't have that perfect roll. I'm setting this up here because I want to take a picture. So I want to make sure I'm kind of styling these as I go. I mean, look at that one. Holy smokes. Alright, so if you wanted to just ice them the other, you know, when they were upside down, actually, which I might do on that one too, because they do look pretty on the upside down. I'm just sort of playing with this idea in my mind. See how it goes. I'm flipping them just because I'm curious to see how they look once they're flipped. You can, so I'm going to keep a couple the regular way, and the others I'm just going to sort of, I'm playing around with. So I'm going to re-stir up my icing to loosen it just a little bit. Tell if it's done. So Jess, mine were the dough on the outside. The outside layer was still a little bit white, but then I looked over and they were nice and golden brown on the other side. So that was a sign that tells me, yep, those are done. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get my icing. I'm actually going to add a little smidge of water to this one because I want to do this. I want to do a design. So when I was younger, I worked at Truffles Bakery in Farmington, and I would decorate the cinnamon buns and the scones and everything, so we'd have this big vat of white icing. There we go. So I'm loosening mine up a little bit because okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm just going down the side. Oh yeah. Now this is really just for presentation and how you want to do this. So if you just want to, you know, take a big glop and just cover the whole thing, good. But I am sort of a presentation person, so I'm gonna go back on this first one, quicker line. Oh baby, I love those. Okay, and so now these other two, my two in the back that I didn't flip. Sorry, food makes me so happy. And you know what? This time, I will take any sort of sweet sugary happiness. So now for my other two, these are my two end pieces. I am just going to spread it on top. So I'm giving you a few options. It's sort of choose your own adventure. So that you would, just spreading on normally. You just put it on the middle. They're nice and warm, so that cinnamon is just, the buns are sort of, it's sort of melting itself. So I have got a couple of options here for you. I don't know if you can see that. That's really, I don't even know who's going to eat all these in this house. We've got 16 cinnamon buns. I'm so glad. Upside down, mine look more like yours now. Yep. All right. So I cannot wait to see your pictures. If you've never baked with these before and you are happy with yourselves, or you're still feeling a little disappointed, I want to hear that too. Yeah, I mean, you can flip them and keep baking them. There was a question, can we flip them and keep baking them? If you think so, if you had 8 cinnamon buns with the same amount of dough that we all had, at 17 minutes. It should pretty much be, so if you feel like they're not done, you certainly can. But this is what it looks like on the bottom. And well, that was the old top, and then because I flipped them. So there we go. If you do want to keep baking, then that's fine, but don't bake them too much because there is a little carryover cooking, which means that they're going to cook a little bit longer after, now that they're sitting. I spread and leak the filling out before basting. Oh, hey, Kathy McKenna, hi. I'm so glad you're here. I think there's more of you here than are commenting, so I'm just so happy that you guys are here, spending a little time with me. Thank you for putting up with my technical difficulties. If you want to come back next week, we're making pound cakes, so we are going to you can do mini loaves, you can do a regular one, you can, if you don't have a loaf pan, don't worry, just bake it. We're just going to bake it in a brownie pan, and it'll all be great. So, oh good, Japanese, oh good. I just want to say thank you, and I'm so glad my family's here, my JCC family, my West Hartford family. I hope everyone's having a great day, and I hope you love how they taste. I love baking these with you, and thank you so much to the JCC for having these great opportunities to virtually keep us all connected and keep our spirits raised and just keep going. We're all in this together, and I know it's been 6 weeks, and who knows how much longer, but these sort of events make it that much easier for us. So thank you so much, and Valerie, thanks you too. Thanks for tuning in, and we will see you next Tuesday at 1 p.m. here on the Mandel JCC's Facebook page. Thanks, guys. Have a great day. Keep baking.